And why, one thing I tell other people is, don't be arrogant. You have come to me, you have been meeting me in my hotel room here. Tell me whether I have behaved arrogantly with any one of you. You cannot do that. You must not do that. There is God inside everyone. That God is what you must respect. But Englishmen who ruled over us in India are in the habit of behaving arrogantly even today. They can't forget that. So this Peter Holt came with that feeling. And when he was talking, I had just seen his horoscope, I had kept it. When he was talking, he started talking, he said, astrology could not have originated in India, it must have originated in some other country. I said, Mr. Peter Holt, it is the same old, closed-minded, blind spot of an English Orientologist. If you or anyone in Oxford or Cambridge University has any courage, come on the same platform. I will give you historical data. I will give you mythological data. I will give you astronomical data, which you are ignoring deliberately. You do not know that astrology could not have in any country, originated in any country outside India. One. Two, you meet one philosophical argument of mine. He said, what is it? Can astrology originate in any civilization which does not believe in transmigration of souls in Punarjanma? What is an horoscope? A child is born sick. Why is a child born sick? Is it the karma of this life? How can astrology originate in any civilization which does not believe in Punarjanma, the results of your karma, karma phala? And today you in America cannot challenge me, because the greatest researches on Punarjanma are being done by an American, Dr. Ian Stevenson, in the University of Virginia. And his brilliant books contain cases of all over the world, and the most celebrated case there is that of Gopal Agarwal of Delhi, who in his previous life was a Brahmin of Mathura, and who is a patient of Dr. K.S. Kerak, and who got an inspiration and designed the cover page of Dr. Kerak. When you see that book of Varshaphala of Dr. Kerak, see the front page and remember the design has been done by a man who remembers his previous life, and the case has been studied by rigid American psychological standards of Ian Stevenson, established. Researches which appeared in medical journals of USA, which have not been challenged. It went on. He was not convinced. Then I said, you arrogant Englishman, you have wasted 300 years in this country. Instead of learning higher things, you have just looted us, plundered and taken away our money, nothing more. He said, why do you say that? I said, Mr. Peter Holt, you came and introduced yourself to me as a journalist and a writer. What you should have told me was that you are an economist. He said, yes, I am an economist. How do you know that? I said, this horoscope. This horoscope is showing that you are an economist. 300 years you Englishmen wasted your time in this country. That's what I am telling you. I look at your horoscope and I know you would study economics to make a career. And you would have done that. You may go into journalism. You also have a spell of army service. He said, yes. Then I said, shall I tell you something more? 89 or 90, you were nearly arrested. You went to jail. He said, yes, it happened. I escaped it. Can you tell me for what reason? I said, perhaps for some drugs. He said, yes. He said, how do you say all that? I said, that is our knowledge. You blind Englishmen never knew that. But I must say, to the credit of Mr. Peter Holt, he went back 1 year after when he came. He spent lots of hours with me. He took addresses from me, met different people, interviewed them, and he says he is writing a very interesting book about India, and he assured me with a sense of humility a rare assurance of an Englishman. And he said, there is a chapter about you in which I have said Mr. Rao has proven and claims that the psychological aptitude being done by people in the West is totally wrong. What I point out as an astrologer is correct. I was sitting in Mr. Chakrapani's house in Los Angeles. He gave me one horoscope of a lady. I wrote out something. In his house, I was writing out and giving to people. So he said,
Los Angeles.
Los Angeles, I was sitting in Mr. Chakrapani's house. I wrote out, I said, you could have done medical course, you might have been a lady doctor. Mr. Chakrapani asked me, how did you know that? I never told you she was a lady doctor. I said, this horoscope, if it is correct, it shows a medical course for her. Like that it went on. Some another lady came. I said, you are an artist. Right from the childhood, you have been brought up in artistic influences. She said, yes. Similarly, I am missing Christina Collins here. I don't know where she is. So when I was discussing her horoscope, I said the same thing. I said, I see a lot of artistic influence in your life. What is it? She said, my mother was an opera singer and I learned music. I write musical notes. In the astrology, destiny and the wheel of time, towards the end, I have given some of these combinations. How you decide these things? See the fifth house from the Lagna and the fifth house from Mercury. See the nakshatra lord of the fifth, the nakshatra lord of the fifth lord from your Lagna. So you are able to get an idea of the patterns of education a man will get. I have given that in that book, illustrating. When I advise people, I first look into that. Then, understanding hundreds of different combinations, I have to have more feedback from you people in USA. One of my purposes of coming here is to link up with you for this great research. We have techniques, you have data. Very rich data you have got in your computers. You take the whole thing and you find out the different educational patterns a child will have. So you are able to give psychological guidance, aptitude test you can do far better through astrology than you can ever do through psychology. Make no mistake. Dr. Charak's paper on planets and doctors is complete. We have not brought it. Another on planets and engineers. Another on planets and army carriers. All those things you'll bring out later. I thought it was too immature for USA. Why I say too immature? As I told you, I do not know when you are in the TM movement and when you are an engineer. So those changes first I must work on, then I'll come to this. Right? Now, having said this, I go back to my favorite method of analyzing a horoscope. Here I will ignore the advanced astrologers completely and go back to everyone. For advanced astrologers, it may be only something like a refresher course. My habit is to give a memory tablet. Why do I call it a memory tablet? Whatever Dr. Frawley and others may do, it is allopathy which dominates, not Ayurveda. And what allopaths do is they give you capsules. We live in an age of capsules. So I also believe in giving education through capsules. And the capsule is PACDARES. That's all the capsule. PAC, three letters, DARES, 5. 5 plus 3, 8. Don't proceed to give any prediction to anyone without making this eightfold analysis of a horoscope. It will actually take 4 days for me to explain these things, but I can explain very briefly and you can read it. and in astrology, destiny and wheel of time, 63 pages I have given in the middle, there most of these things will be clear to you analytically. But PACDARES, what does it mean? P is posited. Where is a particular lord placed in your horoscope? Placement. P is placement. For example, if the Lagna is Sagittarius, where is Jupiter posited? In the seventh house. P means position of the lord of a house. Where is Saturn posited, the second lord? In the fifth house. If you see the Sagittarius horoscope. Where is the third lord posited? In the fifth house. Where is the fourth lord posited? In the seventh house. Fourth lord is Jupiter. Am I too fast? Where is the fifth lord posited? Mars. In the seventh house. Where is the sixth lord? Venus posited. In the seventh house. Where is the seventh lord? In the eighth house. Where is the eighth lord? In the third house. Where is the ninth lord? In the eighth house. Where is the tenth lord? In the eighth house. Where is the 11th lord? In the 7th house. Where is the 12th lord? In the 7th house. This is P. First of all, you must see which planet has gone where. If you do this, later if I do Gemini and Pada Lagnas and Upapada Lagna and Padas, you will understand the technique, how I am saying that. This is the basic rudiment you must do, because this is the stepping stone to higher research in Gemini. It is the first technique you must always adopt, even to give predictions through Parashari Vinshottari Dasha. And later it becomes very useful for Gemini. Gemini astrology, J-A-I-M-I-N-I, Gemini astrology. Both are interlinked. Don't think they are separate systems. It's a system within a system. P. A. Aspects. In aspects, you have to remember those aspects of Parashari. Every planet aspects the seventh house. And in addition, three planets have special aspects. Jupiter 5 and 9 in addition. Saturn 3 and 10 in addition. And Mars 4 and 8 in addition. What is the significance or philosophy of these aspects? What is the significance? Is there any philosophy? A very great Sanskrit scholar, Sitaram Jha, who gave us the most brilliant translation in Hindi of Parashar Hora Shastra. Unfortunately, it is not available. The translations you have in English are very misleading, let me tell you. They are very misleading. A real great Sanskrit scholar who understands that particular secret meaning of Sanskrit grammar as given in Parashar Hora Shastra alone can explain. For example, in this book, Astrology and Planets and Children, I have given some idea in chapter 12, page 118, interpretation of the codal names of the lords of Saptansha divisions. No English book will give you this, let me tell you. And I took the help of two Sanskrit scholars in teaching, with us in Bharati Bhavan, in the Bharati Vidya Bhavan, in the research group. I have given their names also, I always acknowledge. Mrs. Neelkanthan and Mrs. Gupta, both are teaching Sanskrit, they are Sanskrit professors. I said, give me this, codal names. They produced in our last seminar a brilliant paper on Dresh Kona Decanate, codal names, and Chaturthansha, codal names. What are these codal names? What is the secret meaning attached to that? That's an area of great research. There the whole psychology of yours, the material positions, the psychological positions, the emotional positions, the spiritual positions, the assets, the liabilities, all begin to open out. They will just use one codal word, Narad, Agastya. But it has tremendous meaning. So we are working hard at it in Bharati Vidya Bhavan. We are most fortunate we have because we are Sanskrit scholars who are our students, Visharad past students. So I said, this is not given in any textbook, please work on this. And they have been producing very good work. Now coming back to PAC, conjunction, C is conjunction. PAC. You must see in any horoscope, first of all, PAC. I'll keep quickly give you an idea. I'll take that Sagittarius Lagna. Lagna Lord in the 7th house. Jupiter. Second Lord in the 5th house. Third Lord in the 5th house. Fourth Lord in the 7th house, etc., etc. Now, what is the meaning of this? Now, if you do not go into this, you do not understand Parashara. When Dr. Charak was talking on medical astrology that day, I had told him specially, okay, remember the advice given by Mr. Chakrapani, in USA don't talk much about health. That is a sensitive spot. So therefore give a definition of health. There are some technical expressions you don't use. You can share that secretly with some of the astrologers, not with everyone. They will get nervous if they come to know it. He used one expression, I was looking at him, I was a little annoyed. But he immediately stopped there, he didn't elaborate. I am very grateful to him, he didn't elaborate. But that is something very important. Very correct meaning will emerge out. One of the meanings that emerges out when I see your horoscope, when some of you have come to me, particularly some ladies, and I said, concentrate on your sadhana. Why I have said concentrate on the sadhana is, I saw certain things in your horoscopes, those ladies. And I said, this is a combination for spiritual bliss. It is not a combination for marital bliss. You say, we have been very unhappy in our relationships. I said, you will be unhappy. Your horoscope does not promise happiness in your relationships. You go to any astrologer, get any prediction. This horoscope takes your life's energy towards a higher channel, cosmic channel. God has to use an axe to destroy something to give you something greater. What you call a story of deprivation is a story of a great spiritual achievement. What you are losing at the mundane level, you are gaining at the cosmic level. A story of material deprivation is a story of extraordinary spiritual beauty also. I am absolutely thrilled to see some of the horoscopes here in America of some of these ladies. There is so much spiritual promise in that horoscope. But when they ask me this question, what about relationship? I begin to look at the ceiling. I said, there should be many holes in the ceiling and from there someone should drop for them. Because I cannot squeeze out of this horoscope a good relationship for them. So when do you look at the horoscope of a woman and say, look here, there's a spiritual energy here. M-A-R-I-T-A-L, in your case, my dear lady, is M-A-R-T-I-A-L. It is not marital, it is martial. Mangal means auspicious thing. Mars, Kuja Dosh, you hear about Mangal. But the same Mars in English is also for martial and marital. So when it is martial, when it is marital, that is where your skill comes in. And it is this placement of the Lagna Lord and the 7th Lord which finally tells you what type of relationships will fructify in your case beautifully. And in a conservative society like India, we make use of the 5th Lord only to predict about children. In your societies, I will make use of the fifth Lord for not merely children, but for also that affectionate relation which you must have. A bad fifth Lord, bad fifth house, and a good seventh house does not promote your cause. In America, both are important for you. In India, both are important for continuation of the progeny. So when I wrote this book, Planets and Children, I had essentially those Indians and those Americans in view who will ask question about children. In USA, you go to many places and get examined and want to know about children. I know of many cases in India when people went, rich people came to USA, went to England, came to India, got examined medically, and doctor said, there's nothing wrong with you, you can have children, but they have no children. Then I worked on it and I found out whenever the dashas of 9th and the 12th laws operated combinedly, and if they did graha shanti, if there was no case of denial of children, they had children. 9th and 12th. And I have given 5 examples. I made them do Santan Gopal mantra, which I have given here at the end. And you have children, but there should be no denial. What are the curses, what are the denials that I have given towards the end of the book? So that is necessary. Why the 9th and the 12th Lord? Normally all predictions you make on the basis of the 5th house, 5th Lord. I have given, in the case of Dr. Raman, I have shown how Dr. Raman is the father of 9 children. 2 more and you today in a full basketball team perhaps. Or a cricket team or a football team. So in India, having a full team is a very normal thing. 11, 12, 13, 14. But it is not in every horoscope that you will have a full team. I had prepared a big sketch of Queen Elizabeth before coming here. I didn't bring it. I'll use that in a different book. I have given an example. I was reading a big book on Queen Elizabeth, and the English person, male or female, I forget, who wrote about it, said within 11 months of her marriage, she produced her first child and almost made it look like a miracle. A miracle for which perhaps Queen Elizabeth deserved a Nobel Prize. He almost wrote in that tone. Then I said, if that is a miracle, then in India there are many women performing this miracle only. Within 1 year of their marriage, they generally have to have children, otherwise within 1.5 or 2 years, otherwise the entire family begins to curse. That is our society. In the America, for years together, you need not have child, your society will not tell you anything. That makes a difference. But there are definitely American women who want to have children. Is it there in their horoscope? Is the promise there? So therefore, the dasha of the fifth Lord comes into play. Queen Elizabeth in 1947, Capricorn ascendant, got the dasha of Venus, fifth Lord, for 20 long years. 47 to 67. I have cracked this joke elsewhere, I will crack it again here. When the first child of Queen Elizabeth was born, I said the Buckingham Palace was not honor bound to inform Government of India that the Queen produced a baby. Why should they? But I said, for courtesy's sake, for the sake of a historical memory, they should have done that. Why? The then Prime Minister of India was Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, 1948, when the Queen became a mother. She gave birth to her first issue on November 14th, which was the date of the birthday of the Indian Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. So for the sake of a historical memory, she could have informed. She waited for 3 years and produced her second baby, a girl. Again, they should have informed. Why? She produced her second baby on August 15th, which is the day of independence of India. Then 10 long years she waited. And everyone in England thought, full stop. No more baby. The But Venus Dasha was on the fifth Lord Dasha of 20 long years, and a beautiful Venus sitting in the second house with Jupiter. No affliction at all. So the Queen of England could produce baby like a great Indian mother. And at the right age, she runs into right Dasha. 10 long years she waited and sprang a big surprise on the world by producing her baby in 1960. After 50, 10 long years. Venus Dasha is on. Then everyone in England thought now there was no more semicolon, it was a full stop finally. But Venus Dasha, Venus was there, Venus said, no, my dear sir, I am still there operating. So she waited for 4 years more, and 1964 she produced her fourth baby. Then the Venus Dasha started coming to an end, and Venus said, my dear queen, thus far and no further. So she produced 4 children in the Dasha of the fifth Lord. That is the normal thing, or the sub period of the fifth Lord, etc. Those principles I have given. But where there is an abnormal delay in the birth of children of 10 years, 11 years, 15 years also, I have given a case of 16 years also, which is abnormal for an Indian family. When I say abnormal for an Indian family, please try to understand, I am dealing with Indian cases mostly. But you can apply the same principle to USA, it will never go wrong. Marriage in 1950, first child in 1961. You can see astrologically why this has happened. You go to a gynecologist later, go to an astrologist first. Always go to an astrologer first. I have given astro-gynecological check sheet also in the book. Take that and check sheet, put the points and find out when a child will be born. Then, why in the case of those who have to propitiate planets, they will have children in the dashas of the 9th and the 12th Lord? Go to the logic. What is the principle? The 5th is the punya of the previous birth, the spiritual minute of the previous birth. There is some deficiency there. That deficiency should be made up through spiritual merit of this birth, which is represented by the 9th house. Then why the 12th? Every 4th house from a house, from house. 9th is the Guru, house of Guru. And the 12th house is being 4th from 9th. Is the ashram of the Guru. I have given one instance of a person who went and took initiation from a Guru, and in the Dasha of the 9th Lord and the Antar Dasha of the 12th Lord, he had his issue. Through Guru's blessings, the Guru helps you overcome a spiritual obstacle by giving you a proper mantra, says do it properly. And you will overcome this difficulty. So the Dasha of the 9th and the 12th Lord becomes significant now. So PAC, now D. What is D? D means Dhana Yoga, wealth giving combinations. Are there wealth giving combinations in this horoscope? Now there are so many combinations mentioned in so many books. You cannot remember it, but you can remember in one simple principle. First you remember, then you read and memorize anything. The one simple principle is combination of 1, 2, 5, 9, 11. 1, 2, 5, 9, 11. The mutual combinations of these will produce Dhana Yoga. 1 is Lagna. If your health is not alright, you can't produce anything in life. Health has to be alright. All the yogas of poverty or deprivation, in those cases you will invariably find the Lagna Lord is weak or debilitated or destroyed. The Lagna Lord has to be alright. So therefore, one must come into play in all achievements of your life. My body is all right, then only I am able to play, speak, write, talk, marry, produce children, earn wealth. So first of all, my body must be all right. One is important. Two, you know, is earning money. So 1 plus 2 is combination number 1. 1 plus 5, combination number 2. 1 plus 9, combination number 3. 1 plus 11, combination number 4. Then go to the second one. 2 plus 5, 2 plus 9, 2 plus 11. Then 5 plus 9, 5 plus 11. Then 9 plus 11. So 1, 2, 5, 9, 11, 5 teams playing a full league match against each other will play how many matches? So when I ask people, they say 20 matches. I say no. 5 multiplied by 4, because each team will play 4 matches, divided by 2 will give you 10. So these are the 10 Dhan Yogas you must see at once in a horoscope. Combination of 1, 2, 1, 5, 1, 9 and 1, 11. Now this combination is taking place in the 6th house. So the man will take bank loans and raise money. It is taking place in the 8th house. He gets windfall money or inheritance. It is taking place in the 12th house. Ask him to concentrate on foreign business. It is taking place in the 3rd house. Ask him to do cooperative work with his younger brother or sister or someone. Now you have to extend those principles, but the principles must be sound. The house PAC, first I told you, first find out where it is taking place. PAC. After seeing PAC, now come to D, Dhan Yoga. But what is the nature of this Dhan Yoga? Where is it taking place? In the 5th house? In the 4th house? In the 11th house? In the 7th house? In the 6th house? In the 9th house? So which relation of yours is involved? Which house is involved? Which place is involved? Which direction is involved? All the secrets come out of this only. But remember these 10 combinations for Dhan Yoga. D is Dhan Yoga. Then the health conscious Americans should remember also 1, 6, 8 and 12 for Arista Yoga. A represents Arista. Arista means malefic combinations. 1, 6, 8 and 12, that is 4 into 3 divided by 2, 6. These 6 combinations create health problems. DA. 1, 6, 8, 12. There are 4. 4 multiplied by 3 is 12, divided by 2 is 6. These 6 combinations are obstructions for good health or enjoyment of many things in life. Everywhere lagna is becoming important. Please remember, myself, Dr. Charak, we have not used our normal terms here which you use in Delhi. We say L and we say LL. So it will look like a formula of chemistry for you. It is not chemistry. L is lagna, LL is lagna lord. When you say 5H and 5L, we mean 5th lord and 5th house. It almost looks like a formula of chemistry, but we use it quickly in our board in Delhi. That saves time. 5H, 5L. So, that is Arista, DA. Arista means malefic. So be careful, note out, is the note down, is there any combination of 1-6, 1-8, 1-12, 6-8, 6-12, 8-12, then see the dasha periods operating, then the transits. Now be careful, Arista can manifest here. Arista means malefic influence, DA. Now I come to R. I'll come to that. Exceptions. I'll come to exceptions later. Arista. Then I come to Raj Yoga. In the traditional agricultural pastoral society of India, Raj Yoga meant getting a job in a government department or in a Raj Darbar, in the court of a king. And in India, we have had so many princes. In 1947, when the great Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel abolished the princely states, we had as many as 580 princely states in India. These 580 princely states were abolished. That was good for the Indian Union, but bad for astrologers of India. Because they lost 580 patrons. Those princely states looked after astrologers very well. I was a government servant, so I didn't need the protection of a prince for my astrology. But there are many who need that protection in India. Full time. The society doesn't help us anymore. So some of the Indian astrologers have become scoundrels. If they have become exploiters, it is because that is withdrawn. So they have to cheat someone to earn money. And the easiest way of cheating money is to dispose of and frighten a man. But princely states were abolished. So Raj Yoga actually meant those days getting a job in a darbar or in a princely state. Now the expanded meaning of Raj Yoga today is position of importance, and stop there. Position of importance, wherever you are, you may be a businessman, you may be a government servant, you may be an engineer, you may be a doctor, you become an important, noticeable man in society if there is a Raj Yoga in your horoscope. Now, what are Raj Yogas? Raj Yogas are combinations of the Kendra Lords and the Trikona Lords, that is 1, 4, 7, 10 are Kendras. And Trikonas are 1, 5, 9. Now, earlier when I talked about Dhani Yogas, I forgot to mention. In the classical concept, the Kendras or the quadrants as you call them, represent Vishnu Sthanas. Out of the trinity of gods, Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh, it is Lord Vishnu who is the protector, who is the giver of happiness. A house, a horoscope in which the fourth house has malefic predominance is a horoscope in which the man cannot have much of domestic happiness. You know that. Happiness is given by Lord Vishnu. Therefore, Kendras are protected. Fourth is mother and house. Seventh is spouse. Tenth is job. And Lagna is both Kendra and Trikona. Health. Health, home, wife, job, and you are in heaven. When one of them is ruined, you run to an astrologer. I am sorry, may I request one of you to give me some hot coffee again? It got cold, I forgot. Dr. Saab, chini do daliyega. Teen nahi. Teen mein jata meetha ho jata hai. Then, D-A-R. Rati, what is Raj Yoga? Now, the fifth house is the Lakshmi Sthana. Lakshmi is the goddess of wealth. The fourth house is the Vishnu Sthana. When both goddess Lakshmi and Vishnu bless you, then only you prosper in life. Now when majority of people come to me in India or here and ask about their spiritual life, I said, if you are a married man, your first duty is to look after your family. Talk about spiritual life later. When you grow old, but continue your spiritual practice. Your worldly duty is what you must perform efficiently. Anapekshah shuchih dakshah udasinah gatavyathah sarvarambha parityagi yo madhubhaktah sah me priya. In the Gita, Lord Krishna is very clear. A real devotee is primarily efficient but detached. Efficient but detached. I have come to US to speak before you. Whether I succeed in speaking well or do not succeed in speaking well, whether I succeed in making an impression on you or do not succeed in impression on you is not my worry at all. I just do not bother to know whether you are giving me a certificate of praise or condemnation. All that I know is my conscience is clear, I am performing my duty efficiently. That's all. That is the lesson I learned from the Gita. Anapekshah shuchih dakshah. Therefore, when you are in the world, you must balance both things properly. Your devotion to God, your devotion to the world. A happy combination of two. And therefore, for the happy combination of these two, you need the blessings of Vishnu and Lakshmi. Therefore, in one of the stotras of Lakshmi, which I read, will I do in the second session, because many of you who want to solve your problems of monetary, this security, you know that problem is there in USA, particularly in the case of ladies who are single parent mothers. I have all my sympathy with them. I weep for them. I know their struggles. They have come to me in India and talked about their agony. The single parent woman in USA represents to me the same male cruelty which dowry system in India represents for the Indian female. It is different in your case. It is not dowry bride burning. But the single parent woman suffering, I tell you, is much worse than the Indian girl paying dowry. It's a much greater social evil you people are facing. Many of these women may not have told you their stories, but they have told me. I have more than 1,000 cases of American women who have met me in India and talked about it. And I always take it as a much worse evil of your society than the dowry system of Hindus. They may not tell you males about it, but they will come and tell me, an Indian who is not concerned with it. They have told me terrible stories. Therefore, I always say, the astrologer is a much greater sociologist than the greatest sociologist of the world. We understand these things better through an insight. So coming back, Lakshmi and Vishnu. When we worship Goddess Lakshmi, one of the expressions we use is Bhukti Mukti Pradayini. Bhukti is worldly enjoyment, Mukti is salvation. God give me both in a balanced, harmonious way. Worldly enjoyment and salvation. Enjoyment when it is time for enjoyment. Salvation when it is time for seeking the higher and achieving the higher. So Bhukti Mukti Pradayini. Therefore the 4th and the 5th Lord. Therefore the 9th and the 10th Lord. And the Lagna is always both Lakshmi and Vishnu Sthana. It is both Trikona and Kendra. Now one of the stupid controversies raised by many people in the astrological books written in English in India. They say Trikona Lords are only 5th and 9th. It is elementary. Trikona means three. Three. I said, you fellows, why don't you say Dvikona? Only two then. If it is trikona, there have to be triangle, can't have two sides only. It has to have a third side. So it is 159. Kendras are 14710. So combinations of 1 and 4 is 1 Raja Yoga. 1 and 5 is 2nd Raja Yoga. 1 and 7 is 3rd Raja Yoga. 1 and 9 is the 4th Raja Yoga. And 1 and 10 is the 5th Raja Yoga. Then 4 and 5 is the 6th Raja Yoga. 5 and 7 is 2nd Raja Yoga after that. Then 7 and 9, another Raja Yoga. 9 and 10, another Raja Yoga. Now I showed you the first case, how I fixed the horoscope of birth lagna of Radu, Romanian ambassador. 9th and the 10th lord in the 12th house. Raj Yoga in a foreign country, he is an ambassador. So to be an ambassador in a high position in a foreign country, the Raj Yoga must take place in a foreign country. In my case, I have my Raj Yoga happening in my lagna, not in a foreign country. I have come to USA to give lecture on astrology, not as in India's ambassador. Not from Indian Foreign Service. Why I was not selected for the Indian Foreign Service when I competed and succeeded in All India competition? Because there is no Raj Yoga connected with a foreign country in my horoscope. So when people come to me, ask me, in India I am competing, what service should I opt for? I said, you fellow, you will go to a foreign country as ambassador or something at some date. Indian Foreign Service, opt for foreign service, and they get selected. The other man comes, I see the influence of Mercury or Venus, I say opt for custom service or income tax service, you will go there. Mercury or Venus will drive you there. So the significance of each planet comes later, but first thing is Raj Yoga. So 1, 4, 5, 7, 9, 10. Their mutual combinations will give you Raj Yogas. Where is it occurring? First house, second house, third house, fourth house, tenth house, etc. Then you go into Gajakesari Yoga, Vasumati Yoga, all those yogas later. First is this basic structure you must analyze yourself without reference to any one of the yogas you have been asked to memorize. Then you see Gajakesari Yoga later.